seated, everyone.
Boy, you guys look great.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before we get started, just a general reminder to please turn off your and silence your cell phones. Leave them tucked away until the ceremony's over. We have a couple of professionals here in the house, Kay and Hawii and Michelle, so they'll be taking the photos. After the ceremony, there'll be an open bar right over here in the lounge area. So when ceremony's over, please just proceed over to that area, not into the tent. They need to finish setting up, okay? Now, who's finally ready to see Alvin and Lindsay get married? Woo! Yeah. It's been a long time coming, hasn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And who could have picked a more glorious spot than this to have a wedding? I would like to acknowledge the parents of the bride and groom. Without them, this day wouldn't have happened. The mother of the bride, Mary Stalvey, and the father, Raphael Lindsay. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to celebrate my first time as an officiant, and possibly my last. For those who don't know me, my name is Matthew Padella, and I was honored when Alvin and Lindsay asked me to officiate their wedding. After a quick application online, anyone can do this, but it's not easy to be up here, especially for Alvin and Lindsay, who have every right to be nervous. This day is about Alvin and Lindsay, and all of you who have traveled so far to witness this day. Lindsay and Alvin would like to thank everyone for coming. I wish you both a lifetime of happiness and joy. There's three things I think that make a happy marriage. And one is to appreciate each other, to communicate, to never go to bed angry. Appreciate each other and never take each other for granted. Mm-hmm. When I first met Lindsay, she was a teenager in high school. And she was very protective of her mother, who I just started dating. Today I feel like a father, and I'm protecting her. She and her brother DJ have welcomed me into their family, and they are both like a son and daughter to me. I am so proud of her accomplishments and the woman she has grown into, and I know she will make Alvin very happy. When I first met Alvin, I have to say I was a bit hesitant. For one, I wanted to meet the kid who kept sneaking in the back door of the house when he came over to visit Lindsay. Come to find out, there was a reason for this. He was terrified of my Doberman Sturgis. Over time, Alvin and Sturgis got to know one another better and began to get comfortable and like one another. And as we got to know Alvin over time, we grew to like him too. Alvin has a big heart and a vibrant personality and is quite a character at times. And I think that's why we all love him. Mary and I agree he's the right person for this family. And I know he will make Lindsay happy. We all ready to get started here? Welcome, family and friends. We are gathered here today to witness and celebrate the marriage of Alvin and Lindsay. This is not the beginning of a new relationship, but an acknowledgement of the next chapter in their lives. Alvin and Lindsay have spent years getting to know one another, and now we bear witness to what their relationship has become. Today they will affirm this bond formally and publicly. Al and Lindsay will mark their transition as a couple, not only celebrating the love between themselves, but by celebrating the love between all of us, including the love of their parents, siblings, extended family, and best friends. Without this love, today would be far less joyous. I want to introduce Kaylee Hola. She's going to do a Hawaiian love.
Aloha.
Mommy.
hold in sickness and in health, in good times and in not so good times, for richer or poorer, keeping yourself unto her as long as you both shall live. Do you, Lindsay, take Alvin to be your lawfully wedded husband, having to hold in sickness and in health, in good times and not so good times, for richer or poorer, keeping yourself unto him as long as you both shall live? May I have the rings, please? A ring is an unbroken circle with ends that have been joined together, and it represents union. It is a symbol of infinity and all your infinite love. When you look at these rings on your hands, be reminded of this moment, your commitment, and the love you now feel for each other. Before you place this ring on Lindsay's finger, repeat after me. Lindsay, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love. With the pledge to love you today, tomorrow, always and forever. And now, Lindsay, before you place this ring on Alvin's finger, repeat after me. Alvin, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love. With the pledge to love you today, tomorrow, always, and forever. I'd like to bring up Kelly.
To the intimate part of the ceremony, the honeymoon, and I talked about this a little earlier. This is a true and ultimate meaning and expression of that word aloha. So all of standing face to face, just as you are, sharing something with someone you know. Ha, your breath, your life, your spirit. And so oftentimes around Polynesia, we see folks greet one another with a honeymoon. So what I want you to do is you're going to gently place your forehead and your noses. You're going to close your eyes. Ho'onani kamakua kau, keke kime kau hanenu, kea kua ma, ho'o mai kaipu, ho ke yao, ho ke lao.
May Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, always be the center of your new lives you are now starting to build together. That you may know or wit the ways of true love and kindness. May the Lord bless you both all the days of your lives and fill you with his joy. Amen. Those who've God has joined together, let no man put asunder. In so much as Alvin and Lindsay have consented together in wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and this company, have given and pledged their faith to each other, and having declared same by giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that you are husband and wife. I ask you now to seal the promises you have made with each other on this day with a kiss. Family, I'd like to introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Liz.
Like we always do with you.
Thank you. them.